Well, my guest is former U.S. Senator Gordon Humphrey, who has endorsed Jim Rubins for the U.S. Senate. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you, James.
So this race has been evolving against Gene Shaheen. A couple candidates are in this race. A couple others may join. Why is Jim Rubins the candidate?
Jim is an outstanding citizen. Look at this, James. This
the
is
union leader.
Yeah.
Citizen of the year.
Sunday's paper.
Right.
There are 1.4 million citizens in our state. Only one gets named Citizen of the Year. This year it's Jim Rubins. And the reason for that is he has a remarkable record of accomplishment, both as a state senator and now as a private citizen. For 10 years, the principal thrust of this piece in the paper was his record of forming and holding together this remarkable coalition of Democrats and Republicans, conservatives, liberals, independents, everyone who was concerned about the efforts of Las Vegas interests mm-hmm. to establish casinos in our state. Now, whether you're for casino gambling or against it, and I'm very much against it, mm-hmm. you have to admire someone who put together that kind of coalition, held it together on a shoestring over 10 years, and did battle with these well-financed kingpins mm-hmm. from Las Vegas and beat them year after year after year. And the result is, thank goodness, New Hampshire is still a family-friendly place, still a place where it's a wholesome atmosphere in which to raise children, thanks to Jim Rubins. So, solid accomplishment. Can I give you a second reason?
Sure.
He's electable. In his first run for office, he knocked off not right. only a state senator, but the man who at the time was the president of the state Senate. And then, so he's proven he can win, even as an underdog, and anyone who's challenging an incumbent
sure.
U.S. senator is going to be an underdog. So he's proven he knows how to do that, persistence, good ideas, has an incredible head on his shoulders, very bright guy.
Well, that is certainly a ringing endorsement from you, a person who held this seat for so many years. Thanks very much for coming in. Now, you can watch more of this interview at WMUR.com/politicalscoop. We have an extended version of this interview, but that's it here for TV. Now back to you. Sorry I had to cut you off there a little bit, but we have more time
yeah.
here online, so
yeah,
let's get some more reasons here.
Part.
I know, getting you fired up. But you work with him. He worked on your last campaign for governor, obviously.
And, yes.
So you know the Republican base, particularly through the Tea Party movement. You can come back a little bit here in politics.
Hey,
this is a base election.
I am
election.
Tea Party.
Right. Well, this is a base election, right? Particularly yeah. Scott Brown's not running. And a lot of people look at Jim Rubins and they say, the guy supports a carbon tax.
Yeah.
I mean, where am I supposed to go here? Why is he the guy for the Republican
base?
I'd
be happy to address that.
Now?
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, look. Would you prefer to beat up on carbon, or would you prefer to beat up on people who create jobs? The bill that Jim supports mm-hmm. would reduce the payroll tax. We all want to mm-hmm. lower unemployment, right? Well, you do that by encouraging job creation.
And certainly that helps more people on the broad base than just the rich with income tax.
This is a very yeah. conservative approach yeah. that ought to please both sides,
sure.
left and right, frankly, because even the conservative economist Arthur Laffer,
the Laffer curve fame, yep.
yeah, of yep. Laffer curve fame, approves, endorses this approach. Furthermore, let me say that Jim Rubins has taken the pledge, the Americans for Tax Reform mm-hmm. pledge. He has pledged that there will be no net increase. He will support no net increase, whatever, during his terms of office. And furthermore, this is really important. He has pledged not to serve more than two terms. Jim is not proposing to become a career politician. In contrast to Senator Shaheen, who now, as of this year, has been in office 22 out of the last 24 years. Give me a break. It's time for somebody new. The major problems we have in this country, the massive problems in Washington, are the result of careerists mm-hmm. in government, especially in Congress. And so for these additional reasons, idealistic and practical and principled reasons, I'm very much strongly in support of Jim Rubins. He can win. I believe he'll win the Republican primary. Mm-hmm. And this is going to be an extraordinary year. Jean Shaheen, however clever she may be, is in big trouble because of her extraordinary vulnerability on the health care, on the Obamacare issue. Mm-hmm. She, like the president, promised, she, in her own words, that those who liked their health policies, insurance policies, could keep them. She knew, had to know, if she read the language of the bill, the principal component required that these policies no longer could be sold after January 31st, just a week ago. It was written in the law, it was written in stone that millions of Americans would lose the policies they wanted and they preferred and hoped to keep.
If the insurance companies decided to change them, which they change them every year. But
they are prohibited now from selling the policies that these people wanted and have now lost. And Jean Shaheen, along with the president, and Harry Reid and Nancy Pelosi lied. There's no other word for it. They lied to the American people.
Well, PolitiFact called it the lie of the year. Now, in 1978, there was a Democratic president. It was a midterm year. There was a Democratic incumbent for U.S. Senate. How does the 1978 election, which you won, compare to this one?
Well, there could be a strong parallel.
Besides the internet.
There could be a strong parallel. You have an incumbent Democrat senator whose party is in big, big trouble. Right. At the time, Jimmy Carter was president.
Right.
If you're old enough to remember Jimmy Carter, you remember, you know, really bad stuff. Stagflation, high unemployment.
Sure.
Things were in bad shape. So an unknown conservative, much less known than Jim Rubens, for sure, me. Since you raised the subject,
that's why I asked you. Yeah.
Managed to defeat on his first try for any kind of office a sitting United States senator. So, you know, the precedent is there. The circumstances are really quite similar. Jean Shaheen's in big trouble. The whole Democrat hierarchy.
Does it feel the same?
Big trouble.
The mood. Does it feel the same?
Yeah, yeah. I'm very encouraged about the prospects. But you know, we dwell too much on politics. Our country's in big trouble. Here we've got NSA spying on us without the warrant required by the Constitution. Massive violation of our Fourth Amendment rights. Every day and every night, NSA is spying on us, even though it has no reason to suppose. Now, there's another area of vulnerability for Jean Shaheen. Over the years, she's been utterly silent while all of this has been going on, and only recently had something like this to say, that NSA needs to do a better job of explaining itself. Give me a break. NSA needs to get back within the confines of the Constitution. James Clapper, who lied to Congress, should be fired, and so should everyone else who's been on watch during this scandal, while NSA has gone rogue wild spying on American citizens. I mean, Washington has become so big, so arrogant, so powerful, that is now defying the Constitution of the United States.
Gordon Humphrey, never at a loss for words. Thanks so much for coming in. I appreciate it.
My pleasure.
And thank you for watching WMUR.com.